In this illustration, I will demonstrate you a light beam normally incident on a hemisphere. Here, the figure shows a glass hemisphere with refractive index 2 is placed on a horizontal surface, and a narrow beam of light normally incident on the surface of a sphere, as we can see here. And we are required to find where the final image will be produced by the light beam. Here, in this solution, again we can see one light beam is incident normally, the central ray will go straight and nearby paraxial rays will be refracted, for which we use refraction formula. But we can see the light is incident on the base of the hemisphere at 45 degrees, and we can see if we calculate the critical angle for glass is this theta c, we can write it as sine inverse of 1 by mu, which is here sine inverse of 1 by 2, that is equals to 30 degrees. And here the light beam is incident on the base at 45 degrees, that means all the light rays which will fall onto this flat surface will be reflected at the same angle 45 degrees, because this is greater than critical angle. And here for refraction, we use the formula mu 2 by v minus mu 1 by u is equals to mu 2 minus mu 1 by r. And with sign conventions here, we can substitute the values. U can be taken as infinity because parallel light rays are incident onto it. Mu 1 we can take as 1, as from air light is coming. Mu 2 we can take as 2, which is given. A radius of curvature we take as plus r, because it is on the left side and we are taking this direction as positive for our sign convention. So in this situation, we are getting the result as this mu 2 is 2 by v, and this term will become 0 because u is infinite. This equals to mu 2 minus mu 1 is 1 by r. This implies the value of v we are getting is plus 2r. That means these light rays will incident on the surface in such a way that they'll converge at a distance 2r from the face. So here we can see, if I redraw the picture for clarity, here you can see when light rays are incident onto this hemispherical base, these are refracted in such a manner that these will converge at a point at a distance 2r from the point of incidence along the principal axis. So as this is incident at an angle 45 degrees, the light rays will be reflected, and in reflection we can say the final light rays which will meet will be at this point on the other surface, because this distance is r. So these light rays will be reflected and the base will behave like a mirror. So for this initial image, the final image is produced exactly opposite to the base of this hemisphere at the same distance. That means the light rays will be meeting at a point on the other face of this hemisphere. So this is the position of final image, we can write as I2. So here we can write, this implies final image will be produced on the surface of hemisphere, which is at position I2 as shown. And this is our final result.